master of the dagger is the one when you start seeing spinal control, okay? So we're basically controlling the human head and the human spine. And we're going to spend the next hour just focusing on spinal control aspect, okay? We're also seeing the first time in the manuscript an applied choke from behind as a throw, okay? These chokes are later found in the Gioco Stretto and are quite painful, okay? So, and there is another technique which is not in Fiore, however is found in several other human manuscripts. It's called Showing the Sun, okay? Which is extremely fun and highly effective. It's primal. It doesn't require, it requires zero training to learn. Okay? And it's all about manipulating the human head. When you're talking about spinal control and controlling the spine, there is one rule. Where the head goes, there goes the body. Okay? So let me show you what to do. Watch. Are you sleeping? Okay. So.
Choke me.
The human body has a certain structure, okay? And it has a certain sense of gravity. The easiest way to take somebody is to come behind him. Very close. So basically I'm joining myself to his center of gravity, right? Now, moving back, and I take him down. Okay? Come on, come on. Not just. Okay? And look what it is. It's hard for him. And my weight is on him. Now I'm on the back. With my you keep him more control, okay? Or if I add his head.
Janky.
So.
Mokro.
Examples of spinal manipulation, okay? Now, the critical example is that I'm basically making him lean back, but not like directly, but mostly to the side and back. Because the human body is kind of very strong forward and backwards, right? Left and right, but like when he does like this, it's like a spiral in motion, he's weak. Okay? So, a spiral in motion, right? And this is what I'm using to kind of like set the second body. And if Fiore shows it, there is a space. Because here I'm supporting him, and he can actually throw me down if he wants. Okay? Still. Here. I'm not supporting it, and his center of mass is here going down. So the only thing supporting him is my shoulder. So if I go down, okay, now all of them away.
But I think the thing that's most worth stressing is the fact that you're gluing your center of mass to his. Without this, this will never work.
Yes. Yes, at the beginning, right? Now, this is like artificial, what I'm showing you right now. Okay, this is for drill purposes. Somebody is not willing, I cannot show you this exercise. In combat, Fiore says there are two ways to achieve this. One, you're very fast. And we all know that when we're very fast, shit can happen, which we didn't want to, and people don't train for mass. And there's like huge hospital bill. Second one, but in reality in combat, very fast. Second one, you strike him. Okay, strike. Boom, 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 okay? Which shocks him a little bit. Imagine if you ever hit your head sometimes, you remember the shock? So this is basically it. This is what we're going for. A shock to the head. And then with that we start applying our techniques. Okay? Now. Unfortunately, unless we are like working in pairs or sleeping behind somebody, we usually people don't usually turn their backs to us. Okay? That's why when we do tournaments, we stand like this, right? In front. So the challenge is to basically acquire the back. Okay? So one of the simplest techniques to do it, and it comes in many different scenarios, is called an arm drag. Okay? And we're going to train in place. First, simple. Well, I will grip his hands with my hands. I will feed it using my full body to my other hand. So I will not go for it because I'm giving him my back. Okay. I will use my full body to feed it. Okay?
Yeah.
And then I will go behind. Alright? And the same thing for him. Gets, feeds, and pulls. Okay?
Super.
Now, the grip should be very high and deep. You can watch like this. Go for a back move. Body. Walk. You're not going to do anything. Okay. So, and it works out with the other hand. Now, if he needs forward, and I leave myself with him, he can throw me easily. So what I need to be lower, okay? But the drill is just that. He grabs my hand, feet, gets my back. Okay? I get his hand. You get his hand. He gets my hand, feet, get my hand, I get his hand, and vice versa. Okay? Pytanie? Cool, let's go. Take somebody down. So, grip, feet, I go as fast as possible. And get him here on the chin. Can be here, here, can be on the face. Well, I usually prefer the chin away from his mouth, and it's kind of good angle to grip. Now here I have to join his head on my shoulder. Tight. Okay? Here I hold him
tightly.
So anything that we do is tightly. Here I hold him tightly. And now, because I'm on his left side, and I'm holding him with my right hand, so with the same hand I'm holding, I pivot around my left hand, left leg, on my right side. And take and pull him down with me. Okay? On the drive, on the left. Okay, on the other side. D. This technique is shown in the horse section of Fiore. He's taking somebody from a horse. You can also see in Meyer, in his dagger section. Okay? And in Marozzo. It's quite effective. How does it work? Pulling him, stretching him on the spine, and I'm just basically like rotating his head. Okay? But it's quite gentle. First technique. Italian. Again. And I want to grip as high as possible as you can. I saw some of you guys doing this. That technique.
Okay, stop.
Okay, this is a Russian tie. It can be done this way, so it's possible. Just a different entry, okay? Just a different entry. From this point of view, we go like this. Together. Doesn't matter. What you usually prefer, and also a weapon holder, is kind of like passing. We do this now. Okay? Okay? Mm-hmm. So previously, then, immediately for the head. Now,
for the neck.
We go for the neck. Sorry. And we should not hit him too hard because it's very painful. Now, a blood choke. It's not very deep. Enter side will be below chin. You're not going for that. You're just going for this. It's not a choke. It's not a blood choke. It's an air choke. It's very painful. So very easy. So here, the pressure is done because not because I'm kind of controlling his head. I'm actually applying pain for him to move. Okay?
Same time, and choke on the biceps.
You can do both. This one is much harder to get, requires much deeper entrance. This one is easier than perish on this one. This is one which happens all the time. Now, you guys saw how easy it was with matching.
Yeah, just one comment after when we are doing this one, we're going down, which should be very accurate because it's very easy to break.
The spine as it's much easier to create the injury during the air choke, and the injury is permanent. Well, you basically smash the trachea, and it can regenerate, but it takes time, and it's an awful injury.
Trachea cavita.
The moment when you go for the butt choke. It takes less time to knock someone out, but it's like when you release it, the victim goes back to health easier.
Possibly. So it depends on whatever we want to do with our
attacker.
So how I did it now. That's how I would like to do it.
That's
and I'm very gentle, so I'm ready. So, still I'm tight. So my head is very close, it's close to him, okay? I'm not like this.
Perfect.
I'm not like this, okay? This is nothing.
Okay.
This is nothing. This. He's like my best boyfriend right now, okay?
It's okay. Moment. I want to have it as a screenshot.
Okay.
So very tight. Yeah, a nice close up right here. You look beautiful.
And I go as deeply as possible, okay? Here, if I can't. Here, if I can't, it's better. And I squeeze. Okay? Okay? And now the same thing. So I go back, opening the space between us. Go back. And pull myself down. Now here, I'm on one knee. Down, one and up. So I can always escape quickly. And I can finish him. Okay, we're not going to do the finish. Okay. Okay. We're just going to take him down. Okay. That's it. Okay, one minute, come. Okay, so we did the body lock, we did the grab, we did the chokes, figure out it's very easy. Now let's go and do a technique called shoving the sun. Now, somebody is going to ask me, Nico, why is this called shoving the sun? Well, I'm going to show you now. So, I start with this.
You can literally do it. Back to doing it.
Alright, so I grip it, pass it, and I pull her, okay? She's been pulled. I get her face gently and show her the sun and turn on the other side. Now, I was very
fun!
So I was very gentle. But this is done very fast. Okay, this is a very fast technique. You literally lift somebody by his head and like a soccer ball, like a basketball. Pilka, Pilka. Okay, slam on the ground.
Wszyscy to trafią. To się nie tak? Nie? Nie, tam
kontrolnie.
Nie, nie, chcę się padać.
Jak jest podanie?
And control.
So one direction and the other direction.
Yeah. Hop.
This is the sound, this is the earth.
Another option would be slightly more brutal. Pass, the back, okay, twist, and pull down.
Whoa.
Can you show that again from the front?
Yeah. So we did it, these actual techniques last 2 weeks ago in Krakow. People who met it, and we are preparing people for like kidnapping women. Because we're doing it, we had a lot like a very big mixed group, and the guys are like taking girls down like this. Okay, so hop, pull, grab her, so twist the head, go here.
Okay. Yeah.
Mm. Compress. Down. Okay? We do it quite fast. Her head is a ball. That's very hard ground. And I slam it. Okay? Now, what is the usual finish?
Moment.
So.
Okay.
So, usual finish here is continue slamming the head down or raise the leg and stomp it like a grape. Okay? And we stomp it.
Otherwise, we stomp the head.
Or kick it. Boom.
Or jumping.
Or you can just fall with the knee. Yes. Okay? Another one here, somebody else. Same technique. Grab, pull, grab, pull. Okay? Stomp on the face. Okay? He should probably not survive. If he does, we have techniques. Okay?
Apply till he doesn't.
Yeah,
okay, cool. Yeah.